mercy, Lord, 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 mercy. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord of mercy. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim. Without defilement, you gave birth to God the Word. Truly, our Lord, we magnify you. In the name of the Lord, Father,
O God, take pity on us and bless us and show the light of thy countenance upon us and have mercy on us.
Amen.
O Lord and Master of my life, take from me the spirit of sloth, despair, lust of power, and I will come. But give rather the spirit of chastity, humility, patience, and love to thy servant. Yea, Lord and King, grant me to see my own transgressions and not to judge my brother. For blessed art thou unto ages of ages. O God, cleanse me a sinner. 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 God cleanse me a sinner and have mercy. O God, cleanse me a sinner and have mercy. God cleanse me a sinner. God cleanse me a sinner and have mercy. O God, cleanse me a sinner and have mercy. God cleanse me a sinner and have mercy. O Lord and Master of my life, take from me the spirit of sloth, despair, lust of power, I will talk. But give rather the spirit of chastity, humility, patience, and love to thy servant. Yea, Lord and King, grant me to see my own transgressions, and not to judge my brother, for blessed art thou unto ages of ages.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of age and world.
Lord, mercy, 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 Lord, mercy. O all holy Trinity, consubstantial power, undivided kingship, origin of all good, be graciously inclined to me a sinner, confirm and instruct my heart, and take away from me every defilement. Enlighten my mind that I may ever glorify, praise, and worship you, saying, One is holy, one is the Lord Jesus Christ, for the glory of God, the Father. Amen.
It is truly me to bless you, all the Lord, ever blessed and most pure and loved.
Thank you.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Place the beams on supper chambers, the waters that make the clouds, his chariot, who walks on the wings of the wind, who makes the Daniel spirits and administers the flame of fire, who made the earth on his foundation, so that it should never be shaken. The deep covered his ugly garment, the water stood above the mountains. At your rebuke they fled, at the voice of your thunder they were afraid. The mountains ascended, the valley sank down to the places you appointed for them. You set a boundary, the sea shall not pass, nor shall they return to cover the earth. He sends the springs into the valleys, the waters flow among the hills, all the beasts of the field drink thereof, the wild asses quench their thirst. Besides of the birds of the air have their habitation, their voices resound amid the rocks. He widens the mountain from his upper chambers, the earth is filled with the fruit of your work. He causes the grass to grow for the cattle and herb for the service of man, that he may bring forth food from the earth and wine that make glad the heart of man, oil to make his face shine and bread to strengthen man's heart. The trees of the field are full of sap, even the seed of the Lebanon which he has planted. There the birds make their nests, the abode of the stork is foremost among them. The high hills are a refuge for the wild goats, the rocks are a refuge for the hyrax. He appointed the moon for the seasons, and the sun knows its time for setting. To make darkness, and it is night, wherein all the beasts of the forest do move. The young lions roar after their prey, seeking their food from God. When the sun arises, they gather together and lie down in their dens. Man goes forth to his work and to his labor until the evening. O Lord, how magnified are your works, and wisdom you have made them all. The earth is filled with your creation. Behold the sea, great and wide, in which are teeming things innumerable, living things both small and great. There go the ships and that leviathan which you fashion to play therein. These all look to you, that you may give them their food in due season. When you give it to them, they gather it. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things. When you hide your face, they are troubled. When you take away their breath, they die and return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. He looks on the earth and it trembles. He touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praises to my God while I have my being. May my words be pleasing to him. I will be glad in the Lord. May sinners be consumed out of the earth, and the wicked be no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul. The sun knows his time for setting. You make darkness, and it is night. O Lord, how magnified are your works, and wisdom you have made them all. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God.
In peace, let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. With faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For as we have entered our metropolitan Tecon, for his eminence, Archbishop Nathaniel, for the honorable priests of the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the president of our country, for all civil authorities, and for the armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Our abbess, Mother Christopher, for the sisterhood of this holy monastery, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and countryside, and for the faithful dwelling in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land, by sea, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance, small affliction, wrath, danger, necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Advocate, and the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, and the sinners, and each other, and all our life, unto Christ our God. Lord, compassionate, merciful, long-suffering, and of great mercy, give heed to our prayer, and attend to the voice of our supplication. Work upon us a sign for good. Guide us in thy way, that we may walk in thy truth. Gladden our hearts, that we may fear thy holy name. For thou alone art great and workest wonders. Thou alone art God, and among the gods there is none like unto thee. O Lord, powerful in mercy and good and mighty, to help and to comfort and to save all those who hope in thy holy name. For unto thee art all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
In my distress, I cry to the Lord that he may answer me. Deliver me, O Lord, lying lips from a deceitful tongue. What shall be given to you, and what more shall be done to you, your deceitful tongue? O Lord, sharp arrows with glowing coals of the broom tree. Woe is me that I sojourn in Meshech, that I dwell among the tents of Kedar. Too long have I had my dwelling among those who hate peace. I am for peace, but when I speak, they are for war. I lift up mine eyes to the hills. From whence does my help come? My help comes from the name of, comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade on your right hand. The sun shall not smite you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time forth and forevermore. I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Our feet have been standing within your gates, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem built as a city bound firmly together, to which the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord, as was decreed for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord. Their thrones for judgment were set, the thrones of the house of David. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May they prosper who love you. Peace be within your walls and security within your towers. For my brethren and companions' sake, I will say, peace be within you. For the sake of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek your good. To thee I lift up mine eyes, and thou who art enthroned in the heavens. Behold, as the eyes of servants look to the hand of their master, as the eyes of a maid to the hand of her mistress, so our eyes look to the Lord our God till he has mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, O Lord, have mercy upon us, for we have had more than enough of contempt. Too long our soul has been sated with the scorn of those who are at ease, the contempt of the proud. It had not been the Lord who was on our side, let Israel now say. It had not been the Lord who was on our side when men rose up against us, then they would have swallowed us alive. When their anger was kindled against us, then the flood of the void had swept us away. The torrents would have gone over us, the raging waters. Blessed be the Lord who has not given us his prey to their teeth. We have escaped as a bird from the snares of ours. The snare is broken and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
And to the angels of the angels. Amen.
Sinless, through the intercessions of the holy Theotokos and of all the saints.
For thine it is to so majesty and thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
As the mountains are round about Jerusalem, so the Lord is round about his people from this time and forevermore. For the scepter of wickedness shall not rest upon the land allotted to the righteous, lest the righteous put forth their hands to do wrong. Do good, O Lord, to those who are good and to those who are upright in their hearts. But those who turn aside their crooked ways, the Lord will lead away with evildoers. Peace be in Israel. When the Lord brought back those who returned to Zion, we were like those who dream. Then our mouth was filled with laughter and our tongue with shouts of joy. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad. Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the water courses in the Negev. May those who sow with tears reap with shouts of joy. He that goes forth weeping, bearing the seeds for sowing, shall come home with shouts of joy, bringing his sheaves with him. Unless the Lord builds a house, those who build it labor in vain. Unless the Lord watches over the city, the watchmen stay awake in vain. It is in vain that you rise up early and go late to rest, eating the bread of anxious toil, so that so he gives his beloved sleep. Woe's sons are a heritage from the Lord, the fruit of the womb may reward. Like arrows in the hand of a warrior are the sons of one's youth. Happy is the man who has his quiver full of them. He shall not be put to shame when he speaks to his enemies in the gate. Blessed is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in his way. You shall eat the fruit of the labor of your hands. You shall be happy, and it shall be well with you. Your wife will be like a fruitful vine within your house. Your children will be like olive shoots round your table. Woe, thus shall the man be blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life. May you see your children's children. Peace be upon Israel. Sorely they have afflicted me from my youth. Let Israel now say, sorely they have afflicted me from my youth, yet they have not prevailed against me. The flowers plowed upon my back are made long their furrows. The Lord is righteous. He cuts the cords of the wicked. May all who hate Zion be put to shame and turn backward. Let them be like the grass on the housetops, which withers before it grows up, with which the reaper does not fill his hand, or the binder of sheaves his bosom. While those who pass by do not say, the blessing of the Lord be upon you, we bless you in the name of the Lord. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. More than the watchman for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord, for with the Lord there is mercy, and with him is plenteous redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all his iniquities. O Lord, my heart is not lifted up, mine eyes are not raised too high. I did not occupy myself with things too great and too marvelous for me, but I have calmed and quieted my soul like a child quieted at its mother's breast. O Israel, hope in the Lord, from this time forth and forevermore. Remember, O Lord, David's favor, all the hardships he endured, how he swore to the Lord and vowed to the mighty one of Jacob, I will not enter my house or get into my bed. I will not give sleep to mine eyes or slumber to mine eyelids until I find a place for the Lord, a dwelling for the mighty one of Jacob. Lo, we have heard of it in Ephrathah. We found it in the fields of Jair. Let us go to its dwelling place. Let us worship at its footstool. Arise, O Lord, and unto thy resting place, thou in the ark of thy might. Let thy priests be clothed with righteousness, and let thy saints shout for joy. For thy servant David's sake, do not turn away the face of thine anointed one. The Lord swore to David a sure oath, from which he will not turn back. One of the sons of your body I will set on your throne. If your sons keep my covenant and my testimonies, which I shall teach them, their sons also forever shall sit upon your throne. For the Lord has chosen Zion, he has desired it for his habitation. This is my resting place forever, here I will dwell, for I have desired it. I will abundantly bless her provisions, I will satisfy her poor with bread. Her priests I will clothe with salvation, and her saints will shout for joy. There I will make a horn to sprout for David, I have prepared a lamp for my anointed. His enemies I will clothe with shame, and upon his own crown, and upon himself his crown will shed its luster. Behold how good and pleasant it is when brothers dwell in unity. It is like the precious oil upon the head running down upon the beard of Aaron, running down upon the collar of his robes. It is like the dew of Hermon, which falls on the mountains of Zion. For the Lord has commanded the blessing, life forevermore. Come bless the Lord, you servants of the Lord, who stand by night in the house of the Lord. Lift up your hands to the holy place and bless the Lord. May the Lord bless you from Zion, he who made heaven and earth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Lady, the advocate of the
Spirit, give her up all the sins of this world.
Spiritually raised in song, the
sinners, forgive us.
Oh.
Wisdom, let us attend.
Thus the heavens and the earth and all the hosts of them were rested on the seventh day from all his work which he had done. Then God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because in it he rested from all his work which God had created and made.
Thou from Canaan in the sixth town, consider and answer me, O Lord my God.
Consider and answer me, O Lord my God.
How long, O Lord, wilt thou forget me forever? How long wilt thou hide thy face from me?
Consider and discretion will preserve you, to deliver you from the way of evil, from the man who speaks perverse things, from those who leave the paths of uprightness to walk in the way of the wickedness, who rejoice in doing evil and delight in the perversity of the wicked, whose ways are crooked and who are devious in their paths, to deliver you from the immoral woman, from the seductress who flatters with her words, who forsakes the companion of her youth and forgets the covenant of her God. For her house leads down to death and her paths to the dead. None who go to her return, nor do they regain the paths of life. So you may walk in the way of goodness and keep to the paths of righteousness. For the upright will dwell in the land and the blameless will remain in it. But the wicked will be cut off from the earth, and the unfaithful will be uprooted from it.
Peace be unto you, wisdom.
Thank you.
removing from me the spirit of sloth, despair, lust of power, and idle talk. But give rather the spirit of chastity, humility, patience, and love to thy servant. Yea, O Lord and King, grant me to see my own transgressions, and do not to judge my brother, for blessed art thou unto ages of ages. Purged of unseemly speech. May clean our lips which praise thee, O Lord, Make our hands refrain from base deeds, and to work only that which is well pleasing to thee, fortifying our members and minds by thy grace. Wisdom, for unto thee our joy, glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Again and again, in peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Master, holy and exceeding good, we implore thee, Lord, rich in mercy, be gracious to us sinners, and make us worthy of the reception of thine only begotten Son, and our God, the King of glory. For behold, his immaculate body and life-creating blood, entering at this present hour, are about to be set forth on this mystical table by multitudes of heavenly hosts invisibly escorted. Grant to us to partake of them without condemnation, that through them our mental sight may be illumined, and we may become children of the light and of the day. Wisdom, through the gift of thy Christ, with whom thou art blessed, together with an all holy, good, and life creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Thank you. Yes, Sean, you're faithful. You can make this a life as well as you do. Whosoever eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood shall abide in me, and I in him. That by thy word, O Lord, dwelling within us and sojourning among us, we may become a temple of thine all-holy and adorable spirit, redeemed from every diabolical wile, wrought either by deed or word or thought, and may obtain thy good things promised to us with all thy saints, who always have been well-pleasing to thee. And make us worthy, O Master, that with boldness and without condemnation, we may dare to call on me, the heavenly God, as Father, and to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven,
soul. forgive me, mothers and sisters and brothers.
In the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Yes, I will bless the Lord at all times. His grace shall always be upon
Lord, this is my sin.
Meet the new member of the Bilas family. Handsome little guy, who changed his clothes during the service, so we know where his priorities are here. Look at him. He is doing the good things, dead to the world. Fast, as fast asleep. We are serving a little meal now in the refectory, so we'll have prayers of thanksgiving and then we'll see over there.
Glory to thee, O God, thou hast not rejected me, a sinner who has made me worthy to be a partaker of thy holy things. I thank thee, for thou hast permitted me, the unworthy, to commune with thy most pure and heavenly gifts. O Master, lovest mankind, for our sakes, this die and rise again, and gavest us these awesome and life-creating mysteries, for the good and sanctification of our souls and bodies. Let them be for the healing of soul and body, the repelling of every adversary, the illumining of the eyes of my heart, the peace of my spiritual powers, the faith and shame, the love and faith, the fulfilling of wisdom, the observing of thy commandments, and the receiving of thy grace, and the attaining of thy kingdom. Preserved by them in thy holiness, may I always remember thy grace, and live not for myself alone, but for thee, our Master and Benefactor. May I pass through this life in hope of eternal life, and so attain the everlasting rest. For the voice of those who teach is unceasing, and the gladness of those who hold the goodness of thy countenance is unending. For thou art the true desire, the ineffable joy of those who love thee, O Christ our God, and all creation sings thy praise forever. Amen.
O Master Christ, our God, King of the ages, maker of all things, I thank thee for all the good things thou hast given me, especially for the communion with thy most pure and life-creating mysteries. I pray thee, O gracious lover of man, preserve me under thy protection beneath the shadow of thy wings. Enable me even to my last breath to partake worthily and within your promise till thy holy saints, for the remission of sins and of the life eternal. For thou art the bread of life, the fountain of holiness, and the giver of all good. Be we ascribe glory with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Freely thou hast given me thy body for my food, O thou who art a fire consuming the unworthy. Consume me not, O my Creator, but instead enter into my members, my veins, my heart. Consume the thorns of my transgressions, cleanse my soul and sanctify my reasoning. Make firm my knees and body, illumine my five senses, nail me to the fear of thee. Always protect, guard, and keep me from soul destroying words and deeds. Cleanse me, purify me, and adorn me, give me understanding and illumination. Show me to be a temple of thy one spirit, and not the home of many sins. May every evil thing, every carnal passion flee from me as from a fire, as I become thy tabernacle through communion. I offer thee as intercessors all the saints, the leaders of the body, the host, thy forerunner, the wise apostles, and thy pure and blameless mother. Accept their prayers and thy love, O my Christ, and make me thy servant, the child of light. For thou art the only sanctification and light of our souls, those who want to be our Master and God. We ascribe glory day by day.
O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, let thy holy body be my eternal life, thy precious blood my remission of sins. Let this Eucharist be my joy, health, and gladness. Make me a sinner worthy to stand on the right hand of thy glory at thine awesome second coming. Through the prayers of thy most pure mother and of all the saints. O most holy Lady Theotokos, the light of my darkened soul, my hope, my protection, my refuge, and my rest, and my joy. I thank you for you permitted me, the unworthy, to be a partaker of the most pure body and precious blood of your Son. Give the light of understanding to the eyes of my heart, you that gave birth to the true light. Enlighten me from death and my sin, you that gave birth to the fountain of immortality. Have mercy on me, O loving Mother of the merciful God. Grant me compunction and contrition of heart, humility in my thoughts, and the release from the slavery of my own reasonings. And enable me even to my last breath to receive the sanctification of the most pure mysteries for the healing of soul and body. Grant me tears of repentance and confession that I may glorify you all the days of my life. For your blessing, your glorified forever. Amen.
Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word, for mine eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people. Light to enlighten the Gentiles and the glory of your people, Israel. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and